Turning to what the Conservative Party is doing at this conference and how it's been. We're 2 years into a government. There was a little dip in the polls a little while ago, but for some reason, the Conservative Party is still massively ahead in most polls. Why is that?
It's not some reason. It is, in a word, horse. And having analyzed both Labour and Conservative approaches, Lib Dem, it's clear that if they let Boris be Boris, if they let the Prime Minister do what he does, he's got an ability to win votes that no other Conservative does. There are people in the North who have been traveling the country for the last 5 months for the Center for Policy Studies. And what is happening again and again is that the public says, I've never voted Conservative before. This guy is not a traditional politician. This guy is not a traditional Tory. And he's getting the votes that nobody else could do. And second, is that he's actually taking positions that Conservatives normally don't take. He's protecting the NHS, he's adding to social care. He's a rock star. And I've seen it here, I've seen it across the country. Everybody wants to touch him. Everybody wants to get a selfie with him. I was watching the camera crew here earlier. They could not keep their hands off of Boris. Mm. That's the kind of guy he is.
It's understandable how he'd alight a Tory party conference, and people sitting here in Manchester will be delighted to see him. There are moments when he's elsewhere in the country where he certainly doesn't attract the same kind of adoration that he did when he was London mayor. To some extent, the Brexit referendum divided opinion on Boris Johnson, and we've seen that in some of the home county seats, in some of the London seats, that the Tory vote seems to be slipping while it's growing in places like the Midlands and the North. In and around London, there's the potential that the Tories are moving backwards.
You can't win every election and an 80-seat majority. He's as popular as Margaret Thatcher was at the end of her first term, perhaps even more so. He's as popular as Tony Blair was at the end of his first term. Britain has never seen anyone who has the ability to reach everyone, with one exception. There's only one exception, and that's Scotland, and it's an important exception. But I believe that if you get the Chancellor, the Home Secretary, and the Health Secretary, who are all doing brilliant jobs, if you have those people representing the policy and Boris doing the politics, that's the best combination. And one more point. I was in school here for 3 years. I look at this Conservative Party right now, I don't recognize it. Mm. Many more women, many more people of color, many more people who are first, second generation immigrants. This is not the Conservative Party that I remember. This is a Conservative Party that can govern for another decade or longer because it is so inclusive, so diverse, and so open to new ideas.
And it is the oldest and most successful political party in the world. Founded in 1834, it seems to be able to reinvent itself over and over again.
Yes, you know your history.
The Tamworth Manifesto, if we really want to get into it. But I want to ask you...
But we got to also focus on Labour and the mistakes that they have made. Jeremy Corbyn is an extremist.
Yeah.
Jeremy Corbyn was not going to appeal to the country. And the Conservative Party, the fact that it barely won in 2017 is a lesson that they should not take this for granted. Mm.
And on that, Jeremy Corbyn is now gone. The Labour conference last week was a bit of a mess in terms of messaging and everything else. But if there's one takeaway that people who paid the slightest bit of attention to it may get...
If the Labour Party ever wants to govern this country, and it will someday, it's going to need to move itself strongly to the centre, and it's going to need a Tony Blair-like individual who knows how to communicate, knows how to legislate, and knows how to implement. And that is not what the current Labour Party knows right now.
With all of that, with Boris being a rock star, with the Tories ahead in the polls, do you think, finally, that there's potentially a sense of complacency here at the Conservative Party conference, that will be in power forever, that Boris doesn't really need to do much, that it's just sort of all fine? Is there not a sense of... Does there need to be a greater sense of urgency?
Because of what happened in 2017, and I don't advocate for either side. I'm a pollster. My job is to tell it like it is. Mm. Because they almost blew it in 2017, I think that's still in everybody's heads, that it can look really great now, 5 weeks from now, after a snap election. You never know what's going to happen. Your politics is more mobile. Your politics is less tribal than American politics, which is a good thing. Your politics is also much more respectful, much more civil. In the CPS work that we did, I was so proud to be part of this because everyone still talks to each other. We don't have them in the States. But I also think that in Britain, no one takes anything for granted anymore.